What we're going to study in this session is using the P-chart and its form of capability to estimate whether your process is stable and predictable and whether it's capable of meeting requirements. Now, for this, I've hijacked the defects per unit simulator and tortured it and made it do things that it doesn't naturally do, what we have here is the number of items that were inspected on a given day. Day one, I inspected 1,006 items. And the number that I rejected, the number that I kicked out, was 111. Those are defectives. Okay, and this will generate 25 data for me. So I'm going to take that data and transfer it over to QuikSigma, and we'll see how to use a P-chart. So here I've pasted the 25 data that we got, reversing the order of the columns. This is the number that I looked at each day, and this is the number of defectives that I found. Now there are four conditions that we have to meet to be able to use a P-chart. One is that the numbers in this column have to all be integers. Well, that's easy. We've got that. And the second one, is that everything in this column has to be able to be classified as having or not having a characteristic. So the characteristic that we're looking for is that they don't pass. So the ones that don't belong to that group do pass. So we know if we've got 1,006 that we've looked at, 111 were kicked out, we know that 895 were good. Now, the third condition is that while I'm taking any one of these samples, the proportion of defectives or the proportion with the attribute I'm looking for has to remain constant. And finally, the fourth condition is that the numbers in this column are independent of each other. In other words, we're assuming that defectives do not come in clusters, that the fact that I got 107 on this day will not help me figure out that I got 150 on this one and 113 on this. Okay, with all that done, we have to make sure that this box is unchecked. Well, in fact, unless that box is unchecked, we don't get this subgroups column. And then we've got a constant sample size. So I could check that and say, give me a constant sample size of 1,000, and I'd be about right. But let's go back here since we've got that data. And let's just click calculate. So we can see that the process is stable and predictable. That is, it's staying within the limits. You might notice, if you've got good eyes, that there are little squiggles in the limits. You might wonder what causes that. Well, let me just go down here and make an exaggerated example. That comes about because your sample size is not constant. And look at that. You see, when I reduce that to 1,500, or excuse me, to 500, I get a little jiggle in my line, and wow, of course, yeah, that proportion's really bad. Okay, the other thing that I get out of this is that I get an estimate of my capability. What we're looking at here is the proportion that are defective, or if you want to think about it, percent. So if I just look over here, I've got about 12.5% that are bad. And in one sense, that's my process capability. I can see that down here, 126,155 average defective parts per million. And I can translate that over into a PPK number if I like. PPK of 0.38 hey, that's a great opportunity. Typically, we want our PPKs to be above 1.5 and 2 if we can get it to get a Six Sigma process. So lots of opportunity there.